To be a football manager, you've got to be egotistical, you've got to be crazy. You're dealing in a world which is in many respects totally different to many others. We're vulnerable because of results, we're vulnerable because of insecurity, we're vulnerable because we allow ourselves to be manipulated by certain sections of the media. And in some cases, we enjoy it.
Howard Wilkinson is held in high regard in footballing circles. He's reached the heights in management. Deep thinking and determined. Track suited with an excellent track record at each of his clubs. A son of Sheffield, he trained with United, appeared briefly for Wednesday, but it was at Brighton where he played the majority of his league football and where he caught the coaching bug. His skills on the sidelines soon attracted the Football Association. He's held a variety of FA posts, for a time taking charge of England's under-21s. In club football, he coached Notts County into the First Division in 1981 and later managed at Meadow Lane. Further success came at Sheffield Wednesday, 5 years of happy times at Hillsborough. At Leeds, he started as a saviour when they looked set for Division 3. After that, he was the inspiration for 2 championships in 3 seasons. The second division in 1990, then the league title itself. In delight or in defeat, he's always had a clear view about the demands of management and its place in his life.
This job is an 18-hour-a-day job, mostly 7 days a week for most of the year. But at the end of the day, we are talking about a job. We are talking about a sport. We are not talking about people's lives. So yeah, it is very serious. Life or death, and more serious than that. We all know the old Shane cliché says. But at the end of the day, we know they're not true. We know they're not true.
Howard Wilkinson, the manager of Leeds United, the boss.
Howard, in particular, the last 2 years of your managerial career have produced the great high of winning the championship and one or two lows since when you've had to deal with the aftermath of that, but throughout you've seemed very controlled and very philosophical about things. Is that the way you just want us to see you, or is that the way you really are?
I think it's the way I perceive the job. I know myself. At best, I'm reasonably shy. At worst, I'm very shy. So dealing with people who I don't know is difficult for me, and that's something I've had to struggle with all my life. It's a bit of an illness, I suppose. And aligning that to the job, I think that it's my job as manager to give players as few problems as possible. And when we won the championship, I felt in that period between Christmas and the end of the season, I did reasonably well in keeping the pressure off them. I felt that last season, when things weren't going so well, I did reasonably well at keeping the pressure off them. I feel that I should be the focus of pressures which won't do them any good. So you've got to work hard at remaining, or seeming to remain, philosophical and under control when deep down you might be seething. You might be very, very frustrated. You might be very, very angry. Because at the end of the day, I'm not in the job, as it were, to satisfy how I feel and satisfy what I want to do at the time. I'm in the job to do the best job for the club and to get results for the club. In fact, to get as good a result as is possible for the club in a game, over a season, over the years. So that means really, I think, if you're going to do the best job, you can't always be yourself. You've got to be the person that fits the situation at the time.
So it's a bit of an act, really.
Yeah. But then, isn't life? Don't we all act?
When you won the championship, you didn't have to act because you within the bosom of your family at home when Manchester United finally failed at Liverpool. You found it very hard to put your feelings into words then. In fact, I think you said you were speechless. Can you now, having sat in the warmth of it all, tell us what it meant to you?
Well, it meant half of everything, I suppose, in a sense, because from my very earliest days as a player, I suppose about 22, 23, I decided or thought that I'd be a better manager than a player. Now, that wasn't a difficult decision, if you'd have seen me play. And once I started going down that road, I knew I wanted to win the first division title, as it was then. And I knew I wanted to win the European Cup. Now, as it is now, I've got to win the first division title again to win the European Cup. So you're talking about 27 years of ambition. So I don't know how you put it into words. For me, the satisfaction was overwhelming. It was all consuming. But the thing with satisfaction is it's not spontaneous. It's satisfaction builds up over a period of time. As the season goes along, the satisfaction's building up. So by the time that Liverpool-Manchester United result had come through, I suppose you sat there like a cat purring. I never have felt the... I remember when we won at Bournemouth and got promotion into the first division. You know, I went away and stayed with a friend of mine, a very dear friend, in the New Forest. I got a lot of enjoyment and satisfaction that weekend. But I didn't need to be with a lot of people for that to happen. I suppose that comes back to the shy bit, the business of, you know... when we're enjoying ourselves, we like to be doing the things and being in the places where we feel most at ease. And in my case, that's with people I know.
Did you never peek at the television that afternoon? Did Ben, your son, bring you all the news? Are you never tempted
to
go home?
No, I never. The guests got up for the table when it went to 2-0, but no, I didn't. No. I said I wasn't going to, and I didn't.
I read in your book that you were listening to another of the Manchester United games, travelling back from a scouting expedition of your own. You heard the score, I think, maybe when they were losing at West Ham, and you switched it off again straight away, didn't listen to it through.
That's right, yeah.
Is that part of your character, that you just... It's easier to pretend it's not happening till you have to deal with it?
When I joined Notts County and joined Jimmy Sirrell, one of the first things I learned from Jimmy was that, you know, management's a very, very difficult job, full of twists and turns and complications and surprises. And that you shouldn't get bogged down in things that you couldn't deal with, over things that you had no influence, you know. And he used to say to me sometimes, where are you going tonight? And I'd say, well, I'm going down to Leicester. Why? Are we playing them, or is there something happening there? Is there a player? And if I'd say no, he'd say, well, why are you going? I'd say, well, you know, it's a football match. And he'd say, you know, you'd be better off at home. Think about tomorrow. Think about the players here. Think about next Saturday's game. Don't make the mistake I've made, you know. Deal with what you can deal with. And if there's nothing down at Leicester that you can deal with, then you're better off investing your time in things that you can.